What about this situation with Mr. Malcolm Jones and the appearance that even if it was a recommendation by the attorneys involved to drop the matter, that it appears that if the PNM covering for the own, someone who was the chairman at the time...
Does the PNM... Let me answer that. The PNM was never in court and the PNM was not involved in this matter. Mm. Let me put this down on the table.
Right.
The PNM was not in court. The PNM was not involved in the matter. As a matter of fact, that decision taken by the lawyers and the board, Attorney General, that matter never came to the government. The cabinet wasn't involved. We had no yea or nay because it was a matter in the court between the board and its lawyers. That was an entirely legal matter. PetroTrin, the board of PetroTrin, had used the Attorney General's office or vice versa to be executing a legal matter in the court where the cabinet has no place, Balisi House has no place, and as Prime Minister I had no place. That matter was in the court being executed in a particular way. The lawyers who were advising PetroTrin, who had advised PetroTrin to proceed to the court, turned around and said to PetroTrin, this matter proceeding to the court doesn't make any sense. PetroTrin board took their lawyers' advice and ended the matter. The only reason why the Attorney General's voice was involved there is because the matter was being executed through the office of the Attorney General. So this was no cabinet decision. It was no government decision. It was no PNM decision. And it boils, and the interesting thing about it, when that decision was taken by PetroTrin board, it brought to an end a $41 million rolling expense. Because interestingly enough, and nobody has looked at this yet, the defense in that matter is a $2.5 million defense. But the prosecution is $41 million. To me, that is where the issue lies. $41 million in state-funded prosecution expenses to lawyers, but the defense only $2.5 million. And of course, what is being said? What was the best decision? Continue it in the court for another 5 years, and that may cost taxpayers another $150 million. And then the argument would have been, why did the board of PetroTrin continue when their own lawyer said to them to stop? Correct. You understand?
I understand, but correct me if I'm wrong. Is Mr. Malcolm Jones not involved in some advisory capacity on an energy committee of this administration?
Malcolm Jones is a member of a 16-man committee.
Why? But if I made a decision that cost my family business $1 billion,
Malcolm Jones was part of a board of a management of a state enterprise.
He was chairman.
Yes, but you are saying Malcolm Jones. We say the board of PetroTrin. We say PetroTrin. Mr. Jones' presence on that committee allows us to get a certain kind of information, a certain kind of insight that because he was PetroTrin chairman, because that was only one of PetroTrin's business. PetroTrin is a multi-billion dollar enterprise that Mr. Jones managed for a long period of time.
Or mismanaged, depending on...
Well, you could say that, but I'm saying the information about PetroTrin as we go forward in that committee, right? It's a committee where we deal with information and certain kinds of information, the insights we can get from him, which we couldn't get from another person, because he was there. So from that point of view, he didn't get an award, he didn't get a salary, he didn't get a this. It's simply part of a large committee. It's, I think, 16 persons. It's a committee called the Energy Committee. And I would find it quite strange if somebody would say to me that Mr. Jones has no information or nothing that can be of value to a committee that is looking at a very complex situation of oil refining in Trinidad and Tobago. So it's from that standpoint, he's there. But if you're being punitive or you're saying, well, listen, since he was involved and he was being sued for $2 billion, let's put it, one can have a different kind of perspective than that.